Our first story, a senior Iranian official says any fresh sanctions by the U.S. will halt a deal reached between Iran and the P5+1 in Geneva. Abbas Araghchi, a senior member of Iran's nuclear negotiating team, says any efforts by the U.S. Congress to adopt fresh sanctions against Tehran would undoubtedly bring the Geneva deal to a halt. He says if Iran's parliament passes a bill to increase uranium enrichment level to 60%, the authorities will be obliged to act accordingly. Araghchi said expert-level talks between Iran and the five permanent members of the UN Security Council plus Germany will resume in Geneva on Monday. He said those talks will last just one day. Joining us now on the line from New York is Don Debar, activist and radio host. Thank you very much for being with us here on the Top 5, Mr. Don Debar. First of all, we know that up until now the U.S. Congress has been discussing the option of sanctions on Iran, and we know that a lot of these activities has caused a stir, at least, concerning this Geneva deal. But what do you think the U.S. Congress is going to do with regards to the Geneva deal?
You have a game afoot at multiple levels here, multiple dimensions. Fundamental dynamic going on in the Congress is the pressure from AIPAC, in particular other lobbying groups, but AIPAC has been trying to force Congress to scuttle any deal that might happen to remove the sanctions against Iran, and as a matter of fact, has also been pushing still for war against Syria. These are two key strategic objectives of Israel to boost itself as a regional player, and also of Saudi Arabia. But there's a larger context, and there's almost a contradiction in terms going on here. You're trying to have peace talks on a small, relatively regional issue in the midst of what is essentially a global military and geopolitical offensive that the United States is taking. You can look to the beginning of that in Africa, for example, at Cote d'Ivoire, when they took the president out at gunpoint using French troops, the invasion of Libya, the war against Syria, the attack in Volgograd today, the uprising almost timed yet again on the streets of Kiev. The United States is conducting a war against its adversaries, quote-unquote, those who have competing interests, those who assert sovereignty. And the idea of having a settlement with this power as it conducts this war on just a, you know, almost collateral issue to satisfy one of its regional allies is almost contradictory. So it's doomed in any event, because the U.S. is trying to, would like to see Iran collapse.
Well, you're saying then the pressure coming from AIPAC, some of the people, especially those inside Iran, are looking at the conditions concerning this deal and whether it's going to be successful or not. They're saying that, in fact, the Obama administration is working hand in hand with the U.S. Congress and wants to keep this threatening language on Iran as it tries to, you know, talk and negotiate on the terms of this deal. Do you think that both are working together on this, or do you think that the Obama is actually under pressure from Congress and AIPAC?
Yeah, it's a variation on the good cop, bad cop game, where it's essentially bad cop and worse cop. The President of the United States could simply make an affirmative statement of reality. Iran does not have a nuclear weapon. Iran has not been pursuing a nuclear weapons program, and the entire history of allegations to that point have been fabrications on the part of my administration and previous ones. That is what a good cop would do in that context, because those are the facts. What is happening instead is he is holding out, because of domestic political pressure to a large degree in the United States, the idea of some sort of rapprochement with Iran rather than the war that many would like to see happen. And you have some in Congress that can't even settle for that. You have AIPAC pressuring really strongly. And you get to see the influence that AIPAC has in the U.S. Senate among the Democratic members of the U.S. Senate and Republican members when you see people declaring that regardless of what the president does, we are going to pass another sanctions bill. But this does happen in a larger context. The attack in Volgograd today could not have happened without backing from the West, and I think that that says an awful lot about the larger situation.
Mr. John Dibar, activist and radio host with us there on the line from New York. Thank you very much.